for everyone watching on YouTube. Experimenting with a new setup today. Give me your thoughts and your feedback on that. Not sure how the long form thing is going to work on a DSLR, but the quality sure looks a little better, I think. Couple of things. I am so excited to really look at this. I found a string company. How about that? Of course, everyone listening, I'm holding up a packet of DR high beams. It's actually a 6-string set, but we're going to start getting some 5-string sets, E to C, from directly from DR. I believe they are on the way as we speak, and I am officially a part of the DR family when it comes to my strings. I'm so excited about that. That's something that I have such fond memories of from being, you know, a young aspiring bass player, and so many great memories of my mentor playing DR strings, Lawrence Cottle, way back in the day, and kind of introducing me to them, and then playing them through college, and them always being great. And here I am, all these years later, officially endorsing DR strings, which is huge. And I've mentioned it a couple of times here and there, Instagram and stuff. It's really been bringing a smile to my face and just an incredible amount of joy when I sit down with the instrument and the intonation is really on point and the tension is right and just everything is right about the string. And it took, as you guys are well aware, it took a while to find it. I've been without any kind of string deal or association with a string company for over a year now. And I really went through a ton of different companies and tried them all out. And a massive shout out to everyone, all the string companies who reached out and sent me strings to try. That's really, I can never be grateful enough to be in this position, to be afforded those small luxuries. So I really appreciate everyone who was involved in the process and just super psyched. Playing these strings. These ones are actually a few days old, still got a little bit of life left in them. I've been playing them like more hours a day than I have in a long time, just really trying to vet them and go through kind of every possible situation on the instrument just to make 100% sure that it's the right choice. And here we are. It is an absolute go. I have some low riders here, which I'm going to put on a 4-string just to check them out. I don't know much about those. I also have another 4-string set of high beams, which I'm going to throw perhaps on the Henrik Linder CNC signature bass, the 4-string. Be interested to see how those feel. So maybe tomorrow on the podcast, we'll be listening to those. Those are still the round core. I believe the low riders are the hex core. And I think I'm going to try out some of DR's flat wound strings because I've never tried those before. But today, the practice room, the reason I'm here is to practice and to get loose. I'm filming the rest of the day after this podcast is done. I'm filming the transcription course, which I'm really psyched about. And right now I'm literally reading out this book, 251 Jazz Vocabulary for Electric Bass. Now I've just lost my page. That is, which one is that? That is exercise 23. It's on page 36 if you are following along at home. By the way, this book is book of the month this month, all of February 2020. It's 50% off at my store and at Amazon as well for physical copies. So those are linked directly below the video. And I'm just rolling around in 12 keys, you know, playing this 251 vocabulary. Probably a couple of times in each key center before changing where we go. We'll do cycle of force. And so on and so forth. listen to how good that sounds up the up in the higher register of the instrument. It sounds like my sound. Like that's, I think that's been the toughest thing throughout the search, the string company search, has been to find my sound. And this kind of, this let me start at zero and kind of ease into it. That's why I put so many, like dozens and dozens of hours on this exact set of strings that's on my bass. That's why I've put so many hours on it in the last few days, just dialing that in. And it's nice to start at zero. It's nice to have a great foundation to work from. Okay, for everyone watching on YouTube, I'm still trying to get this lighting thing right. Yeah, I see the reflection right there of the overhead and then the backlight. It's a work in progress. One I shall really dial in as soon as the podcast is done and I actually look at this footage for the first time. Is the cool thing about it. I kind of have the even feel no matter where I'm playing on the neck. Let us get back to the task at hand here. Which is really just dialing in my kind of all 12 keys and just flexibility for the day. A lot of this vocabulary in the, I think I mentioned this on the last episode, in the transcription course I'm about to release, so much 251 stuff. So this is actually a really good way of getting into that. I've just realized I haven't muted my phone, so I'm going to get to that before somebody texts, before the inevitable happens. Also, I don't think on the podcast I announced, I'm kind of all over the place here, but Ross Kingsford was our giveaway book, 3 book and 1 CD giveaway winner. Ross Kingsford in Australia, I believe. So congratulations to Ross. I think I spaced on announcing that on the podcast. The 3 books and the CD are making their way, albeit slowly, I would imagine. Australia is pretty far, but they're making their way to Australia as part of that giveaway. Congratulations to Mr. Kingsford there. You will have the benefit of being able to read out of the 251 book very shortly, my friend. Else, you get, as a viewer on YouTube of the podcast now, you get a little better view of the mechanics of what's going on with my instrument. I guess you can even see my the settings on my amp back there. Not that that really matters so much in such a small environment, but and not a fashion statement, the beanie is essential today. We're going through a little bit of a polar freeze. Well, at least for Southern California standards. We were down in the high 30s last night, Fahrenheit. And it really hasn't got going so much this morning in terms of heat, despite having central heating here. Mm. And I will make a vlog about the strings as well. This is just a quick announcement in the podcast. I will make a kind of a nice produced video and go into a little bit of detail about the process and the story and my history with strings and why I'm here now. I think that will make kind of a interesting vlog. It'll be fun for me anyway, just to put it all out there and put the storyline in chronological order. Now I really have to check, triple, double, quadruple check that we're still recording here. A little bit nervous. That's why I loved the GoPro situation. Like this little guy kind of never died on me in 50 something episodes in the podcast. So I'm always a little bit nervous with the DSLR that it might overheat, something like that. We shall see. Maybe it will help me make shorter and more concise podcasts. But I do like the long form. So remains to be seen as to how much this view will stick around. Amazing the difference between hammering or playing every note. The simple stuff. What was in the looper? Oh, what is this? I was working on that idea. One, two, three, four, one. Gotta stay so relaxed on that. Almost so relaxed that you feel like your fingers aren't quite on the string. I don't know, it's a weird feeling to describe. Like being so relaxed that you're almost, it's like a very fine line of where the pressure is on the string. And really, I'd have to think about that. Formulate a little bit of a better explanation, I think, for that. But if I'm tense or my shoulders are up or like I'm really like really trying too hard, then it's never going to come out as fluidly as it could. It's almost like it feels like bad technique when it's super relaxed, but it's actually probably when I'm at my most efficient. Freeze pedal is back. It's in the ballpark, I think. Oh, I gotta get back to that. It's a weird one doing this transcription course because it's a lot of information. It's a lot of different stuff, but stuff that's also, again, quite similar in terms of the tradition and the history of the music. It's like a lot of 2-5-1 vocabulary, very melodic, playing over similar changes in a lot of places. So to retain all of this information, it's a pretty nice challenge. That's another good one as well. So what is that? D minor? It's just minor thirds. Okay, not so complicated. That's a not bad one. I guess that would be if you were doing four key centers, D, F, A flat, and B minor, pretty standard minor chords in minor thirds. Let's get a medium up. Nope, that's a multitude of things there. Turn the delay off. Oh, and then hit the button at the right time. Minutes or so, okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm also realizing I should probably have thrown a GoPro up just as a failsafe to make sure we didn't run out of frames halfway through the podcast. Haven't done Q&A on the practice room in a while, so perhaps now would be an opportune moment for, if you are watching, listening, whatever, to go over to the YouTube page and leave a comment or a question for the next episode. It'd be kind of cool to answer some questions, get a dialogue going here. We can talk about anything from music to strings to Yeti lemon water and all kinds of stuff. Whatever you want to talk about, I'm more than happy to indulge. For the most part, I realize I'm just setting myself up for a bit of a disaster by completely opening the floor there. But yeah, chime in. Let me know what you think about the new setup, the new look. If this could be replicated on a regular basis without disaster, maybe we should try doing that. What am I going there? That was, aside from all my yakking in the middle, that was a pretty efficient 20-25 minutes. When I have such a heavy filming schedule, a long filming schedule rather, today, that is probably about it for the podcast. Blow kind of all my chops, and nice to be at this point to go in to start filming. So, ladies and gentlemen of the bass world, wow, there's a total brain fart there. Ladies and gentlemen of the bass world, thank you for hanging out in the practice room. Don't forget merch below, book of the month linked below, and chime in below the video. Questions and comments for the next episode, I'm guessing tomorrow, and more to come on the DR situation and my fresh relationship working with this company that I'm super super excited about. And also coming very soon is the story about the amp, my million mile amp that from Aguilar, my very first one. Going to make a vlog episode about that. So plenty of filming to be done here. Strings, amps, all kinds of stuff. Pedal board update. I'm going to try my hand at soldering cables for the first time. I can already sense a little bit of a disaster with that. But I'm going to give it a shot. Because I don't think the schedule's quite going to work out for Mason to be able to do the full pro board before I leave on tour with Bob. The mix and the master with Bob Reynolds' new record is done. It sounds ridiculously good, I got to say, even though I did play a small role in making it happen. It really sounds good. Everyone kind of did an amazing job, and everything lined up in the right place, and we got it done in super double quick time. So I believe the tentative plan is to release probably three EPs, digitally speaking, over the next month or two. Maybe a few tracks will come out as we leave for Europe, and then you will be able to buy the full CD at our shows in Europe. And we are leaving in like 3 weeks or something. It's coming up. We start in Stuttgart, we end somewhere in the Netherlands, and there are 12 or 13 shows in total. So go to my website, janekgwizdala.com, go to bobreynoldsmusic.com if you want to check out tour dates, buy tickets, etc., etc. Come out and nerd out on basses and pedals. I'll be there. Yeah, again, thank you for sticking around and giving me some of your incredibly precious time. I really appreciate that. And I'll see you. See, how am I going to do this? See, I normally do the see you all on the next one, and then there's like a click and bye-bye. So maybe with this, I'll just grab the lens cap and go, I'll see you on the next one.